This talk is part of a series presented by the TechAid AI for Good conference and hackathon. Our goal with this virtual event is to highlight technological innovation driven by artificial intelligence and directed towards beneficial areas such as health, environment, accessibility, and human rights. Importantly, we also aim to raise money for Centraide, or the United Way, a nonprofit dedicated to fighting poverty and social exclusion. And this is where you can help. Please consider donating by clicking the link in the description of this video. Any amount will be greatly appreciated. Also, if you're watching this before November 12, 2020, consider registering to our event for a chance to ask questions and interact with our speakers. This event would not have been possible without the help of our sponsors, such as DeepMind, Ubisoft, Evado, and Dell Technologies. We thank them for their generous support. Please visit our website for a full list of sponsors and partners.
Particularly, we'd like to highlight our gold sponsor, CDW. Proactively mitigating risk will never be easy. It's ongoing, it's daunting, it's confusing, but it's not impossible. Let CDW and Dell help you with a solution to keep you protected. With 24/7, 365 Security Operations Center, they are well equipped to keep your organization safe. And with that, we'll leave you to our feature presentation.
Hello. Thank you for this opportunity to talk about this important topic, AI for good. My name is Dmitry Konevsky. I'm a research scientist at Google. I'll be talking about how AI can help people who do not hear to have an understandable speech. AI can help such people to speak and listen. Before I speak about wonderful technologies, let me explain what you see on a screen. You see that my speech is transcribed. I have a heavy accent, and this transcription is provided by Google Speech Recognition, a phony that is specifically trained for my voice. I'll be talking about this tool in my talk later. Just wanted to note that this transcription may have errors, but in general, I expect that these errors do not prevent understanding my messages. Recently, after many years of efforts, automatic speech recognition accuracy was improved significantly. One of the factors that helped to improve speech recognition accuracy at Google is the following. In machine learning, computers learn solutions by finding data. To develop good speech recognition, one needs to have a lot of speech training data. This data consists of two corpora, spoken audio and text. It consists of spoken phrases and captioning of these phrases. This data is used to train acoustic models based on recurrent neural networks. There are a lot of different patterns and how people speak. To capture all such patterns, one needs to collect a lot of voice data and transcribe it. Such data collection effort became possible with YouTube. It had a lot of voice data with transcription that is provided manually when videos are posted on YouTube. There could be errors when people put captions manually. Therefore, a filter is needed to select audio with good manual transcription. The availability of this corpora was one of the factors that led to creation of speech recognition capable of understanding most people who spoke in various noisy conditions. This also led to development of speech recognition applications to help people to communicate. These wonderful applications are like transcribe, like caption, slide captions, mid captions, recorder, Euphonia, Paratron, Google Transcribe, Google Translate. These applications made a transformative impact on many people around the world by enhancing how they speak and listen. This is a wonderful example of how AI can be good for people. Just speech application that I would like to talk about is like transcribe. It can transcribe speech in over 80 languages in virtual real time with really high accuracy. It is available for free download on Android phone. Like transcribe transformed life of many people who do not hear. It allows children to talk to their grandfather who does not hear and was not allowed visits because of pandemics. It can help people who lip read when they do not speak lips. We show this in two video clips.
And I miss you, and I hope you're doing okay. But some of our patients and service users rely on lip reading to communicate, and wearing a mask makes lip reading almost impossible. I found that using this app called Google Live Transcribe and other voice-to-text transcribe apps can be really, really beneficial in communicating with those patients. If you found this helpful, please share. Thank you, and stay safe.
Speech recognition does not work well with non-standard speech, heavy accent, etc. The research project Euphonia enables users to train speech models and then get recognized well even when their speech is not very intelligible to the average listener. In order to get Euphonia personalized acoustic models, users need to record some phrases. Euphonia is a research project. We show the video clip how standard speech recognition understands my voice compared with Euphonia, and another video clip about Euphonia. This is a demo to show how Live Transcribe is compared with Euphonia. Google has very good general speech recognition, but if you do not sound as most of people, it will not understand you.
No one's ever collected large data sets of people whose speech is hard for others to understand.
People who have multiple sclerosis, for GF, who had stroke, who stutter.
They're not used in training the speech recognition models. I mean, the game is to record things.
What's the temperature today?
And then have it recognize things that you say that aren't in the training set. Dimitri recorded 15,000 phrases. It wasn't obvious that this was going to work. He just sat there and he kept recording.
We need to make all voice interactive devices be able to understand any person who speaks to them.
You can see that it's possible to make a speech recognizer to work for Dimitri. It should be possible to make it work for many people, even people who can't speak because they've lost the ability to speak. The work that Shenxing has done on, you know, voice utterances from sounds alone, you can communicate. But there might be other ways of communicating.
Most people with ALS end up using an on-screen keyboard and having to type each individual letter with their eyes. For me, communicating is slow.
Steve might crack a joke and it's related to something that happened, you know, a few minutes ago. The idea is to create a tool so that Steve can train machine learning models himself to understand his facial expressions. To be able to laugh, to be able to cheer, to be able to boo. Things that seem maybe superfluous, but actually are so core to being human.
I still think this is only the tip of the iceberg. We're not even scratching the surface yet of what is possible. If we can get speech recognizers to work with small numbers of people, we'll learn lessons which we can then combine to build something that really works for everyone.
To understand and be understood is absolutely unbelievable. And that's a wonderful research project at Google that aims at people with an understanding that speech is paratron. Paratron is attention-based sequence-to-sequence model trained using parallel corpora of input-output speech pairs. Fudge and his team demonstrated that this model can be trained to normalize speech from any speaker, regardless of accent, emotions, complex prosodic patterns, imperfections, and background noise into the voice of a clean, single, predefined target speaker with a fixed accent and consistent articulation for prosody. I myself recorded a corpus of 15 hours of speech, which was used to adapt to the base model, the nuances specific to my speech. This is different from end-to-end automatic speech recognition that maps audio into a text. And it is also does not use end-to-end text speech that maps text into audio. Paratron is end-to-end speech-to-speech model that maps an input spectrogram directly to another spectrogram without any intermediate discrete representation. This is overview of the Paratron network architecture. The output speech is from a different gender, having higher pitch and formats and has a slightly slower speaking rate. The encoder takes the male spectrogram in and the coder produces spectrogram in auxiliary ASR decoder to predict the graphic of phonemes transcript on the output speed, conditioned on the encoder latent representation. Such a multitask trained encoder can be thought of as learning a latent representation of the input that maintains information about the underlying transcript. Another trick that helps to improve paratron recognition accuracy is to use text-to-speech to generate more training data for paratron. First, one trains a paratron model with a user voice. Next step is create a text-to-speech with user voice if user recorded data. Then generate 10 million text sentences random from LM. Then synthesize them with user's text-to-speech model. Then pass the synthesized user data to paratron with user voice model. After this step four, we have only American English accent from fake user. Some will be bad due to paratron or language mode or fake user text-to-speech. So you pass whole output to a standard ASR engine. In this step, We retain only utterances if we are less than 30%. Then one adds this fake good utterances to the real user data. And in the final step, train a new user paratroon. When transformer encoder and the text decoder ASR are used, it allows to achieve 10% word error rate. This is an example of using the improved Paratron model.
Mountain View and New York.
What is distance between Mountain View and New York?
Show me the direction to opening.
Show me direction to opening.
How many children Barack Obama has?
How many children Barack Obama has?
How much? 5 times 10.
How much 5 times 10?
I am working with Paddy Bajatsi.
I am working with.
I am working with Paddy Bajatsi.
I am working with Paddy Bajatsi.
My name is Dmitry Konevsky.
My name is Dmitry Konevsky.
This is fantastic application.
This is fantastic application.
This example also demonstrated that Paratron can produce a speech that sounds correct while decoded text is wrong. In this example, speech recognition does not recognize well when I speak the name of a person. Fudge, who led creation of Paratron, but normalized pronunciation of this name created by Paratron is good. End-to-end speech recognition systems based on the recurrent neural network transducer architecture allow it to achieve state-of-the-art a performance for large vocabulary continuous speech recognition. RNNT model has also been successfully deployed to run efficiently on mobile devices. A phone is trained on cloud, but is used for decoding on mobile devices. Similarly, in the support user data and models are stored on user devices. They are not sent to a centralized server. This increases data privacy and security. Federated learning was helpful to increase speech recognition accuracy, since it is allowed to collect some data on how user speaks while using the JBoard without undermining user privacy. Some of challenges pertaining to on-device training of ASR models due to limited memory and storage. To train the model on device, we split the gradient computation into two and achieved memory reduction at the expense of increase in training time. Personalized models are trained on user devices to minimize the user effort needed. Personalization methods that aim at learning new name entities. The user may then optionally edit the recognition output to correct errors. in put speech and correct text I started in the training cache on the device. During the second phase, data from the training cache is used to perform on-device personalization of the speech model. Biasing is a technique where new vocabulary is injected into the speech recognition system by boosting the language model probability of the new words during the coding. It requires a training of the existing models and can be used as a form of language model interpolation. This training process on device training can be started with a previously trained phonia model, and then new phrases are added on device. It uses one learning short method to quickly add names while talking to the board task. The email, messaging, writing in Google Docs, etc. The following demos demonstrate how one can add names in personalized Gboard. First, we show how it understands names before training.
Juva and Suki are co-founders of Access Israel.
Then how it understands names after training, in which these names were added and spoke.
Juva and Suki are Juva and founders of Access Israel. Of Access Israel.
Similarly, one can add math expression, as in this example. Another example of on-device models is live caption. This is a Google product that allows to transcribe videos, messengers, calls, any voice data in pixel phones. This is a demo of a concept on how call could be transcribed by live caption. Not all features shown in it are available now in pixel phones.
Hi, this is Nicole's assistive chat. She'll see what you say, and her responses will be read back to you, starting now.
Hi, Nicole, it's Jamie. How are you?
Hey, Jamie. I'm good, and you?
Great. Are we still on for your 1 p.m. haircut tomorrow?
Sorry, can you do 3 p.m.?
Yes, I can do 3 p.m. We have a lot to catch up on. I want to hear all about your trip.
Perfect. Thumbs up.
Great. See you tomorrow. Bye.
The next remarkable development that we would like to talk about wearable AI for social good. When people read transcription on the phone, they cannot watch a person at the same time. Having transcription running in glasses would allow users natural social interactions. Sunglasses that run transcription from live transcribe were developed at Google. This is a research project.
Wearable subtitles, augmenting spoken communication with lightweight eyewear for all-day captioning.
Dima, when you are done washing dishes, can you please put a salad for me into the plate?
Okay, I'll put salad.
In this work, we explore the potential of a proof-of-concept eyewear display system to augment the communication for deaf and hard-of-hearing individuals. In contrast to mobile phones, eyewear can enable hands-free access, mobile use, and be more socially acceptable and convenient across many everyday activities. Eyewear might be particularly beneficial for activities where the user's hands are occupied, where users want to focus on a primary task with maintained awareness of speech or instructions, or in general want to avoid split attention between a handheld display and social interaction. We developed a proof-of-concept thin client architecture that is lightweight and low power to enable the private display of transcribed speech for a full workday. We worked closely with Dmitry Kanevsky, a hearing accessibility researcher who relies on transcription and lip reading. These videos were filmed through our display with the live system to show what the wearer experiences.
So what I'm hearing from you is that group conversations are particularly challenging when you have multiple speakers and you need to follow who is speaking. And with the phone, you say it's difficult. Can you tell me a little bit more why?
Yes, if phone, I don't know who is speaking, but if I'm using glasses, so I'm looking on one person. When person finishes to speak, another person starts to speak immediately. Eyes of this person look on at another person.
So even though the current implementation does not separate the speakers, you can associate by following and being more aware of the dynamics in the room and across different speakers.
Yes. So when I use glasses, I really know who said what.
To evaluate our proof of concept eyewear, we ran a number of studies with various activities, such as group conversations in a controlled environment. Our findings suggest that eyewear have the potential to increase awareness during multi-speaker conversations. Our participants expressed that group conversations were particularly challenging, that eyewear would be a welcome technology to facilitate participation.
Please be careful, this fish has a lot of bones.
Oh, really? Thank you for telling me this.
Sarah, would you like some water?
Yeah, I would love some water, please.
Oh, I'll give you water.
Thank you. Thanks so much.
Our results also suggest that eyewear have a unique potential to improve conversations in mobile contexts.
When you are walking on the street, it's difficult to watch phone and talk to person who walks near you. But that you can see everywhere, cross road, cross street, that's the same thing. You can understand what another person talk to you.
For all-day comfort, our revised prototypes emphasize a balanced design and personalization through customizable nose bridges. The nose bridges help with individualized fit, alignment of the eye to the virtual image, and enable adjustment of the image location. In our technical evaluation, we characterize power both from a system and communication scenario perspective. At around 260 milliwatts, we can support continuous streaming of transcribed speech for 5 to 15 hours, depending on the desired display brightness. Wearable subtitles shows that eyewear have the potential to improve hearing accessibility through privately transcribed text, which can be used hands-free, in mobile contexts, and in socially acceptable interactions.
You can find more information about the Euphonia personalized board and Paratron on this and next slide. This is a pointer to wearable glasses. We demonstrated how many goods one can bring artificial intelligence to people. This is only the beginning. More applications can be expected to be helping people in all areas. This talk is a part of a series that aims to collect money for CenTrade, a non-profit dedicated to fight poverty and social exclusion. I urge you to click the link in the video to donate and support them in fighting poverty.